What's up, guys? Lon here from Android Authority, and this is the ZTE Axon 10 Pro. And this phone is probably the best value that you can get in a smartphone that isn't available in the United States. The Axon 10 Pro starts at 599 euros, which makes it a huge competitor to the OnePlus 7 Pro, and it's got many of the same core specs to compete with not just the OnePlus 7 Pro, but many other high-priced flagships. It's got the Snapdragon 855 with plenty of RAM and plenty of storage. There's even a 12 gigabyte of RAM version, but that particular model is only available in China. So with these specs, it was really no surprise that the Axon 10 Pro performs extremely well. It's really quick, really responsive, and something that also helps is the super clean software. You could basically call it stock plus because there are some additional features from ZTE, but it's integrated pretty seamlessly, similar to how OnePlus handles Oxygen OS. All of ZTE's features are neatly tucked away into one section of the settings menu, and most of them are pretty useful. You've got a built-in screen recorder, a bunch of different gestures like double tap to wake, and the option to use gesture-based navigation or traditional on-screen buttons. There's basically no bloatware on here either. There are only a couple of apps pre-installed from ZTE, and many of the default apps like the Dialer, Messages, and Photos app are actually Google's own apps. The software is about as close as you're gonna get to something like the Google Pixel. Battery life is another strong point of the Axon 10 Pro. The numbers aren't exactly outstanding, but I averaged between 5 to 6 hours of screen on time, and I've always been able to comfortably get through a single day. It even has wireless charging, which is really nice because this isn't a feature you're always guaranteed to get when looking at phones around this price point. Now the Axon 10 Pro has some really great hardware, but it doesn't do anything that's super unique. But I personally don't think there's anything wrong with that though. Not every phone needs to have some sort of pop-up or flip-out mechanical part or turn into some sort of Swiss Army knife. And the Axon 10 Pro just focuses on being a really good phone, and it does that extremely well. It's got a thin and sleek design and a big, bright AMOLED screen. It's not super punchy like Samsung displays are, but the colors are still pretty good. The display does have a notch, but it's a small water drop style notch, which I personally don't mind at all since it doesn't take up that much space. It also has an in-display fingerprint sensor, and it's generally pretty quick. It doesn't feel quite as fast as the Oppo Reno that I reviewed recently, but it's fast enough and reliable enough that I don't think very many people will have any problems using it. I would say the area that the Axon 10 Pro needs the biggest improvements is the cameras. It's got a great sensor with the 48 megapixel Sony sensor that a lot of phones are using, and it's paired with a 20 megapixel wide angle lens and an 8 megapixel telephoto lens that gives you 3x optical zoom and a 5x hybrid zoom, but the image processing could use a little work and the lack of OIS really hurts it in low light. Low light shots just don't have enough sharpness, and because of that, details look pretty muddy. The night mode helps out a lot with boosting the shadows and taming the highlights, but it doesn't do much else. The photos still have a soft look to them regardless. Photos taken in bright conditions do look much better. Colors are a little flat for my taste, but the photos are nice and detailed. Having the ability to zoom in at 3x optically is also great because you're still getting a really sharp and crisp image, and the 5x hybrid zoom also does a pretty good job at retaining detail. I'm a big fan of wide-angle lenses, and the one on the Axon 10 Pro works about as well as any other that we've seen. It isn't quite as crisp as the main lens, and you can spot smudgy details pretty easily, but I do like that it has anti-distortion, which keeps everything in the entire frame perfectly straight. Aside from the cameras having a few issues, this phone doesn't really have too many flaws. It's a pretty well-rounded smartphone and is a great alternative to phones like the OnePlus 7 Pro and the ASUS ZenFone 6, especially with how competitively it's being priced. Anyways, let me know what you guys think about the ZTE Axon 10 Pro down in the comment section below. And as always, if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. We definitely appreciate it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll talk to you in the next video.